Hi everybody, Dr. Jordan here with Advanced Spine, and today we're going to talk about sacroiliitis. So pretty much what that means, anytime you hear the word itis after something, primarily it is the inflammation or something is inflamed. So if we're talking about sacroiliac, that is the joint we're speaking of. So sacroiliitis is inflammation of the sacroiliac joint. Now, a lot of times when anything is inflamed, it's typically tender, sore, it aches, it doesn't feel good. What we usually want to do is take an anti-inflammatory or put some ice on it to calm it down, and that does give us some relief. But what I tend to ask a lot of my patients here is that actually helping us fix the problem, or what is causing that inflammation? What is causing the sacroiliitis? This is usually just a symptom of something, and the easiest, most basic thing we can kind of put that against is joint restriction. So the sacroiliac joints are very small joints, and they're actually located right between the sacrum and the iliac, and it makes this little joint that actually does not move much, but we get a lot of our flexion and extension from it. So someone who might have sacroiliitis or just a restricted sacroiliac joint might kind of feel like they're stuck, or they can't really straighten up, or it hurts to bend over. Typically, you can kind of experience something like that. Everybody has a little bit different of a presentation, but that is what I expect to see. So if that is the cause, which that is the most basic common thing I see in the practice here, what do we do about it? Well, as a chiropractor, I adjust restrictions in the spine. So when something is restricted, typically what that means is it is not moving correctly. When I'm saying moving, all our joints or bones that stack on top of each other make up a joint. Joints are meant to move, okay? Sometimes through life, we can talk about falls, slips, just repetitive work, sitting constantly, doing the same things over and over. We're gonna kind of form bad habits in our bodies, and things aren't gonna work like they should. And this is what can cause restrictions or just stiffness in joints. So when that is not addressed quickly enough and it kind of just stays there, and we, you know, take some anti-inflammatories, we put a little bit of ice on it, it feels good for a little bit, then it starts coming back and we kind of just brush it under the rug. Nothing ever gets fixed, and something that doesn't get fixed is going to eventually break down. Okay, so we want to get that fixed. We want to get that adjusted. When we're talking about adjustments for the sacroiliac joint, we can get this a few different ways by gapping that joint, but if we wanna be real specific and actually make sure we're gapping it, it's gonna be a little bit of a different adjustment. Now, typically through the lumbar spine, we wanna put rotation in it, okay? Each joint can move in a number of different directions. We can move forward in flexion, backward in extension, lateral flexion, rotation. For the SI joint, it does not have all those motions, so we kinda just wanna gap it and get some motion in there. So what I'm gonna do to specifically address the SI joint, which is located right here, we are going to lift up the sacrum ever so slightly and put a little bit of motion in it. And it gaps it really nice and quickly. It is painless, feels pretty good. Typically one adjustment is gonna create a lot of relief and it will feel good, but we need to restore the normal or natural motion of that joint. So sometimes it takes a little bit more than one, and it kind of depends on a case-by-case basis. If you're dealing with anything like this, or you have something that you think might be going on that can be addressed by us, please don't hesitate. Give us a call. I'd be more than happy to sit down and talk with you. All right, it was nice talking to you.